Hello, Hoya fans. Welcome back to another episode of Catching Up with Coach T. My name is Brennan Thomas. I'm here with Georgetown baseball head coach Edwin Thompson, better known as Coach T. Coach, how are we doing today?
Doing great. Great. It's a nice day here in Washington, D.C., and a great day for practice and get ready for the weekend. So it's a beautiful day.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, let's talk a little bit about this past weekend. Last time we talked, you guys were getting ready for a big series against St. John's. And the series couldn't have gone much better. You guys won 3 out of 4 for a big series win in Big East play. Talk about what you were impressed about your team's performance.
Well, you know, I think we were just kind of settled in after the first 4 games, not having a shortened preseason. So it was able to, just guys were settled. Guys were calmer. We saw that on Wednesday against Towson. We felt that, or last week against Towson, they were really starting to settle in, just being more comfortable at the plate, on the mound, in the field. So all those things kind of, we knew it was going to take time. But it was great to see our kids where they competed all weekend long. And, you know, if we had a pitched at times better on the game one of Saturday and played and had some more hits, we could have won that game as well. I mean, so it was every game we were competitive, which are always our goal is to win every series. But, you know, it's hard to sweep at Division I level, especially in a 4-game series. But, you know, I'm proud of our guys, how we competed.
Right. Awesome. Big news came out on Monday. Junior left-handed pitcher Angelo Tonis, Big East pitcher of the week, dominant Friday night with 7 innings, only one hit, 8 strikeouts. Talk about his performance that you saw on Friday and how that set the tone for the entire weekend.
Well, I think it allowed us to win it, you know, in a 4-game series. Pitching is critical, and to have our bullpen pretty much saved throughout that time was awesome. His energy, was just how he was going about his business and attacking the hitters like he was, or making good plays behind him, doing defensive work. And you really, you know, we were defensive plays away from a no hitter. I mean, that's really how good our pitching staff did. Coach Caven did a great job of setting up a great game plan, and our defense followed suit. And so happy for him, happy for us. But ultimately, you know, anytime you get a pitcher to go 7 innings on a Friday night and the result is what we wanted, that's an amazing job. And obviously, you know, recognized by the Big East, which is well deserved.
Right. No, it was a great performance and glad he got that recognition. Off the mound, you guys, you know, on the mound, off the mound, you guys had great individual performances from everywhere. You guys were led offensively by a pair of freshmen, Michael Eze, named to the Big East Weekly Honor Roll. Christian Ficca could have deserved the award as well. Talk about what you saw out of them in their first full Big East weekend and how they led the team.
Yeah, I think they never really get the moment too big or too high. They just kind of stay consistent, and they've been that way all year. And you know, playing college baseball hasn't changed. You know, and these kids didn't have a senior year; they had no fall, and so the fact that they're doing this at such a high level consistently is really a tribute to them. Ultimately, I mean, they're just Coach Mac, our hitting coach, has done a great job of getting them prepared with a plan, and they've executed the plan to a T. And I think that's ultimately says a lot about the kids, but also just how they are. And they're just really some good players that we have, and we're fortunate to have them as freshmen. And, you know, but, you know, all around the board, our offense did a great job this weekend of just putting pressure on St. John's, and in situations, if the other team scored, we came back and scored. And we just kind of were relentless in that area at different times. So it was great for them, but ultimately our offense really was a plus, as well as our pitching all weekend.
Yeah, it was great to see. There's some clutch hits all weekend. And speaking of that, you guys had some late inning comebacks for wins, you know, tight games behind, tied, and then, you know, big outbursts at the end of games. Talk about the composure that your team showed, you know, especially just being just a handful of games into the season.
Yeah, I think there's three things I always stress is, you know, making sure we have great passion throughout the game. You know, number one, throughout the entire time, we want to stay poised when things aren't looking great or they're looking great. And also we want to have a purpose. And there's always a saying, you know, you want to, you know, have a big play when it matters the most, you know. And so whether it be a home run by Tony Barreca or a big hit by AJ late in the game on Sunday, you know, those things matter. And sometimes, you know, whether it be early in the game, late in the game, but it's just as much as certain guys getting bunts down, right, and just doing their job and doing their part, moving a runner over. So it was just a thing that our passion was amazing all weekend. Our energy was great. We finally started to execute when we needed to and get those 2-out hits and get those 2-strike hits and just kind of extend the innings, which are early backbreakers for the other team. And so that part, I was really proud of our guys, just as a collective group, not to worry about the score, just play the game.
Awesome. All right, moving on from St. John's, you know, great series win, but that's in the rearview mirror now. Yeah. Unfortunately, Wednesday, or the midweek game this week was with GW was canceled. So no action for the Hoyas this week, but a big weekend series coming up with Creighton this weekend, 4 games in 3 days again. What can we expect to see from the Hoyas to help come out with another series victory?
Yeah, I mean, I think every weekend is going to be a big weekend. You know, right? Every weekend's a playoff weekend because our season's condensed, and now we're just basically playing in the Big East play. So I think every series is going to be a fun weekend to be a part of. You know, for our success, it's really simple. It's like anything. If you pitch well, play good defense, and have timely hitting, you're going to have a chance to be in every single game. And I think that's always going to be our goal. And having this past weekend with some success late in the game, we know we can come back. We have that in our bag of tricks, if you will. But just more so the energy to continue on. Guys, again, more bats under their belts. We should be calmer. Hopefully start to see better pitches. Guys that haven't pitched as well as that they like, hopefully they kind of settle in. And just kind of just be out against a really good team. We know Creighton's good. I mean, UConn, St. John's, and Creighton are predicted 1, 2, and 3 in our league. And so we know that every weekend is going to be a challenge for us to go out there and perform at the level we want to be at to ultimately get in the conference tournament. That's our objective. So we just want to continue to focus on each game one at a time and, you know, kind of go out there and see what it all shakes out in the ninth inning. But we're glad to be, you know, here playing home again, and we're fortunate to have that. And we're looking forward to from that standpoint.
Awesome. Well, thank you very much for your time, Coach. Good luck this weekend, and go Hoyas.
Yeah, Hoyas, actually, we'll look forward to having another time next week. Look forward to some better updates, continue updates what we're having. So thanks so much, Tim.
All right, thank you. And for all your Georgetown needs, including video streams and live stats, tune into GUHoyas.com.